The only source of knowledge is experience. The best way to multiply your happiness is to share your experiences. Greetings to one and all. With the blessings of His Holiness, Sri Sri Shivratri Deshikendra Mahaswamiji, it's my immense pleasure to welcome you all for today's session, Vidya Shakti, sharing the best practices for best learning outcome, conducting under Hub of Learning KK1175, and today's topic, Action Research. Myself, Mrs. Pratibha from Science Department, JSS Public School, HSR Layout, Bangalore. Distinguished principals, respected teachers, and my dear colleague teachers, a warm welcome to each and everyone. Let's begin the session by seeking the blessings of Lord with short virtual opening prayer.
शुभं कुरुत्वं कल्याणं आरोग्यं धनसंपदः
Discussing about action research, what, who can do this action research, why we have to do this, and when we can do this. We will also discuss about steps and process of action research. I have my team who will be presenting their case study in the subject science, mathematics, and English. Before closing the session, we will have check our understanding and then share our opinion. So it will be a feedback session, a Google form will be shared, and we'll also have an interaction session. So this is the flow line for today's program. Let me introduce first to my team. The team is led by our principal ma'am, Mrs. Geetika Karola ma'am, myself Pratibha, HOD from Science Department, and we have Mrs. Shashikala ma'am from English Department and Coordinator, Mrs. Savita, Coordinator from Maths Department, and Mrs. Neeta from Maths Department. Let's know the objectives of this session, like why we have to do this session or sharing of best practices. It is to focus on competency-based education so that students attain specific skills, knowledge, and abilities for better academic career and lifelong learning process, and to succeed in their learning process, to identify problems and seek solutions systematically, reflect on assessments by improving professional practice, and lastly, to emphasize on 21st century skills, that is collaboration, communication, creative, and to improve their critical thinking. The moment I tell you about the objectives, many questions comes into your mind. The first one might be like, what is this action research? How is it connected to the academics? And how can we connect it to classroom teaching? How can we make our classroom teaching interesting and enjoyable? How the learner can enjoy the process of this action research? How to involve them in our process? And what are the steps, how we go about? Okay, so many questions are there. I'll just share a short video clip so that you will get a view of what is action research.
Teaching is a craft. It's both an art and a science, which is why great teachers always experiment and make tons of mistakes. But how do you know what's actually working? Well, one option is action research. Here you can identify a question, test out a strategy, gather data, and determine if it works. The end result is something dynamic, innovative, and tied directly to your classroom. Action research dissolves the barrier between the participants and the researchers. In other words, the teacher actively participates in the situation while also conducting the research. There are many action research frameworks, but they generally follow a similar process. You start out in phase one, planning for research. Here you begin with inquiry, where you define a specific research question. It needs to be something that can actually be tested. Next, you conduct a literature review to gain a deeper understanding of the topic. Finally, you move into the design process, where you determine your data methods, consider ethical issues, get the required permissions, create deadlines, and set up the systems. Next, you move into the action phase. This is where you engage in multiple cycles of experimentation and data collection. Your data collection might include qualitative data like observations, artifacts, and interviews, or quantitative data like rubric scores, surveys, or achievement data. Afterward, you move to analysis. You'll often start by organizing the data with charts or graphs and looking for specific trends. You might also discuss it with peers, free write in a journal, or create a cluster map before eventually writing out your results. Finally, you have your conclusion. This is where you share your research with the world and reflect on your own practice. This will ultimately lead to newer questions, and the cycle will continue as you refine your craft as a better, more creative teacher.
Yes, I hope you would have got a big picture about what is action research. Before going to in detail about what is action research, now I would call upon our principal, Mrs. Geetika Karola ma'am, to give her a review of today's session. Over to you, ma'am.
Namaskara, am I audible?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am, you're audible.
Namaskara, with the blessings of His Holiness, Sri Sri Shivaratri Deshikendra Mahaswamiji, it is our privilege that we, as a hub, KK1175, is hosting the Vidya Shakti series. And in our hub, we have schools, five schools, as Assessi School, Ria Academy of Learning, Delhi Public School, St. Sophia Convent, and JSS Public School, HSR. It indeed is a proud moment for us because, as the name says, sharing of the knowledge, and action research is just about that, where you get into action and then you generate knowledge, which is something which is based on the actions that you take, and then the findings emerge, and then you again go through many iterations. Friends, action research, I would say we are all familiar with our roles as facilitators, mentors, gurus, guide by the side, etc. But when you become action researchers, you become reflective practitioners, because when you are teaching in a class, you teach, you reflect on the class and perhaps go to a parallel class and teach again. And then you have reflected on what you have said and improvised on things where you felt that you faltered, and then moved on and teaching the second class. Now, what happens, the transition between the first class and the second class, you all are definitely more... Excuse me, please mute. Notes. Friends, please mute. Thank you. So what happens between one class and second class? Your delivery is more efficient and you have reached your learning outcomes that you set out to achieve. You have reflected on your practice. The whole idea of action research is that you document this practice so that this documentation becomes available for your other teaching fraternity and they can learn from this tacit knowledge, which otherwise, if not documented, is restricted to the person who's speaking. So action research allows educators to go through actions with the purpose of developing their personality, and professionally they grow. They become actual participative practitioners. And in action research, you have stakeholders, the teachers, the parents, the students, everybody is an active part of the research. Now, what happens? The simple process of action research is plan, act, observe, and reflect. You plan. How do you plan? What do you decide to plan? Based on the needs that you have. As a practicing teacher, you may feel that in English, children are writing long drawn sentences. And if this is not corrected, the children perhaps continue to do that same mistake in higher classes also. Or in mathematics, you feel that children are not able to divide fractions. And this competency is important because in a senior class, it becomes an important integral part to solve a word problem. Again, in mathematics and in social science, a teacher might feel, why our children are not doing very well in math skills in class 10? Perhaps, you know, in the junior classes, we have not developed the skill of math skills amongst the children. So if these common errors are addressed at the right time by a practicing teacher who feels that it is her need to address this problem, this common error, the error will be rectified, children will be more active learners, and they will perform at a better level. Now, when I say the teachers create and generate knowledge, they create and generate knowledge in areas like concepts and topics and phenomena and an idea. All these areas can be worked on. When I say idea, perhaps a principal or a teacher might feel that why the lunchbox the children get to school has got a lot of junk food. So she can deep dive and do an action research on that. Or a teacher might feel that how music can affect the quality of learning of students. That could be one of the another area. Why children come late to schools if they do? Or how do I develop a skill of reading in children? A librarian may feel. So the domain of action research is not restricted to academics. It cuts across all other areas that you may feel. So finally, teachers, I would like to say that it is something which is live. Nowadays, we don't like to take static photographs, right? We want to take live photographs. This is something live. This is dynamic. And the action comes from the findings that come. So it has iterations. It keeps on going through iterations and more interventions so that our quality of teaching and learning enhances. With these few words, I now hand over the session to Pratibha ma'am. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you for briefing about action research. Now let's go into the definition of action research. Experts are given different definitions for action research. It simply means that the process in which participants examine their own educational practice systematically and carefully attempt to solve problems and improve professional practices in their classrooms. Who can conduct this action research? It can be conducted by the teacher. It can be for the teacher. It can be for the betterment of the students in their learning process and to check their learning outcomes. It can be done by an individual teacher or it can be done by team of teachers, okay, in association with other peoples in schools. Now, why action research? Why we have to take up action research? It provides qualitative data you can use to adjust your curriculum, content, delivery, and instructional practices to improve student learning process. When we can do this action research? Action research is used in real situation. Its primary focus is on real problems and solving those problems by using different strategies. In schools, as education is not static, it is dynamic. It helps educators develop practical solutions to the problems, and it's applicable for school-wide problems like attendance issues of the students or attendance issues of helpers in the school, late coming, academic performances, many more like this. Okay. Now, let's go into the steps and process of action research. We have four major steps in action research: planning stage, acting stage, developing stage, and reflecting stage, which follows with the sub steps. Like under planning stage, you have identification of the problem, gathering information about it, reviewing, and then developing a research plan. Then under acting stage, there will be collection of data and analysis of data. Based on that, we do the action plan by using different tools. And then after we do the process of interventions, reflecting stage, where we record the data, we analyze it, and we share it with our teammates and with different schools, what we have done, how we have done, and what are our results. So these are the steps and process of action research. Let me take science as an example and explain you each and every step. Before going to that, I just want all of you to join with me for this physical activity. Around 8 tasks will be given to you. You will have to act accordingly. So I request all participants to do this physical activity. Note that you should remember all the tasks in order. In the sequence only, you have to remember the task. Okay. Hope all of you are ready. You can show me your thumbs up once you, if you are ready. Yes.
You can all my videos, dear.
Yeah,
dear,
you can all audio your videos, participants. Yes, it's a time for us also to relax, to cheer up. So I request all to join together. So your first task comes like this. Count numbers backward from 10. Yes, yes, come on, you can do it. Yes, cry like a baby. Cry like a baby. You can wipe your eyes and cry like a baby. Yes, wave your hands above your head. Wave your hands above your head. Okay, stamp your feet. Stamp your feet. Gently wipe your eyes. Very gently wipe your eyes. Yeah, very good. Yes. Rub your hands. Yes. Snap your fingers. Okay. Now, last task. Say the word brain 3 times. Brain, brain, brain. Again, repeat. Brain, brain, brain. Repeat again.
Brain, brain, brain.
I hope you had a little bit of relaxation through this physical activity, but actual task comes now. You have to tell me, you can text it in the chat box. What was my third question? This is the actual task for the participants. Now come on, tell me, what was the third question? Third task which I asked you. Okay, wave hand.
Wave yes, your Aarti hand.
Ma'am. Yes, Aarti ma'am has given the correct answer. Yes, thank you ma'am. Yes, many, many your answers are coming. Very good. Thank you for active participation. Which was my seventh task? Seventh task, last but second one.
Wipe your eyes.
Oh, sorry, ma'am. Sorry. No. Any other guesses? Yes, Sheila ma'am is giving. Yes, Seema ma'am is giving the correct answer. It is snap your fingers. Yeah, thank you all. Thanks for active participation. Let's move on to the next step. Steps in action research, that is planning stage. So first we have to identify the problem area. Now, how to identify the problem area? Teachers have several questions they wish to investigate or to ask. However, it is important to limit the questions to one that is meaningful, doable, and in the confines of their students' learning. It will be confined to their classrooms or to the classes which the teacher will be teaching. So we have selected such feasible problems, and we have stated here, like in mathematics, it's the concept of decimal division in class 5 students. In English, we have to check the creative writing skills in formal letter writing. And in science, to check the ability of cracking assertion and reasoning questions. That is to check their critical thinking level. So I'll go ahead with my science research. okay, the science problem statement and how we identified the problem, what are the interventions we have done, how we have followed this with last step, how we have evaluated and all those things. So let me start with how we have identified this problem. So our problem statement is to analyze the ability of reasoning and critical thinking concepts taught in science through quantitative methods. And the students participants are from grade 9 and 10, which was conducted in JSS Public School, HSR Layout, Bangalore. Okay. So how did we do this? So before going to know how did we do this, let us first know what is this assertion and reasoning question. Assertion is a simple confident statement, and the reason will be the explanation for the assertion statement. So there will be two statements given, assertion and reasoning. Assertion is a simple confident statement, and reason is another statement which will give the explanation for the assertion. Four options will be given, as you can see in the slide on the screen. Option one will be both A and R. Assertion and reason are true, and reason is not correct explanation of assertion. Second option will be both assertion and reason are true, but reason is not correct explanation of assertion. Third option will be assertion is true, but reason is false. And the last option will be assertion is false, but reason is true. So out of these four options, one option the student supposed to select. Okay. I hope you got the idea of what is an assertion and reasoning question. Let us take one example. And I want participants to actively participate to give the answers for this. Your example is on the monitor. Assertion statement will be seeds should be treated with fungicide solution. And the reason statement is seeds do not germinate unless treated with fungicide solution. Can anyone reply for this? What is the option? Yes, Sheila ma'am is giving the answer C. I think one more, there is a option C answer from director office. Yes, very good. Very good. Thank you for active participation. Yes, it is option C. Okay, it is A is true, but R is false. So we have to analyze this question first. Yes, seeds should be treated with fungicide solution before sowing into the soil because it should be disease free, right? But the second statement says seeds do not germinate unless treated with fungicide solution. It is not true. It is not a rule that it has to be treated with fungicide, otherwise it will not germinate. Nothing like that. Okay, so the option is C. Okay, so this was the assertion and reasoning, the topic which we have selected for our research. Okay, why did we select this assertion and reasoning topic? To learn the strategy and to tackle verbal reasoning questions through critical thinking. So for this purpose, we have selected this assertion and reasoning and to apply in their daily life also. Once we identify the problem, now we must start collecting or gathering informations about how much students know about solving this type of questions. Reason behind poor performance, to check their declarative and procedural knowledge, and we'll start making strategies like what we have to do next, how to do, how, what are the tools we can use, what are the methods, strategies we can use to improvise the understanding of the concept of assertion and reasoning. So we use various tools like checking their records, doing interviews through journal methods, and many more methods. So through all those tools, we can check the performances of the students, and then we collect the data. Okay, on the monitor, you can see the different tools we have used in the slide, which is experiencing, inquiring, and through examining. Once we collect the data, then the next step is analysis of data, analyzing the data, which can be done in two methods, qualitative analysis and then quantitative analysis. So different techniques we can do this. Here are some of the samples we have collected from class 9 and 10 through qualitative method. Class 9 through their pen and paper test and through common errors, we came to know that The child is weak in attending this assertion and reasoning questions. So these are the samples from class 9 and these are the samples from class 10. Qualitative analysis is done through observations, through checking, through common errors, and we try to analyze the causes and we develop hypotheses and we'll make strategies to reteach the same concepts with different methods and different interesting approaches which will be convenient for the teachers and to the students. So once if we know the cause for the problem, it is easy for us to hypothesis the action and then to find out the strategies or different interventions so that we can do our action plan and work on that. So we have different tools, different interventions while we are doing our action plan. Like we have some communication strategies. We can use prompts and clues. We can take up the repeated practice to improve skills. We teach the concept. We take a review whether the students have understood or not. And then we reteach the concept. When we reteach the concept, again, we have to use different strategies like student-centered, blended learning, in science, inquiry-based learning, activity-based teaching, etc. So we have included inquiry-based instruction, think and pair. So these are the strategies we have used in science, okay, to motivate the students to overcome their learning abilities. We have used dual coding, that is combining words and visuals, that is a part of flipped classroom techniques. We have used many online sources like conducting quiz, posing the questions through Google Forms. We have arranged expert sessions where those experts can reteach the concepts so that students can understand better and clarify their doubts. We have lab activities. We have conducted lab activities so that through hands-on experiences, through learning experiences, they can understand the concept. We have given many worksheets, which is based on basic level to higher level. They were assigned to the students. It was self-assessment. This is one more assessment pattern where students can self-analyze and self-assess where they stand. Here we have the samples of those questions, which we have used for worksheets. So this gives practice for our students to repeatedly understand and review their capability of attending these kind of questions, that is assertion and reasoning type of questions. Next step, the last step of this action research process, that is evaluate or assessment process. So before that, further with the next step and the last step of action research, it is evaluation or it is assessment, okay? So assessment is very important for the learner and even for the teachers also, okay? So after we revisit, reteach, we conduct pre-test and post-test, we collect the data and we record it. We record the data and we analyze it in the form of number board or in the form of graphical representation through bar graphs or through pie charts, okay? So once if we record it and we develop the graph, okay? So overall improvement in the periodic assessments will be observed. And the raw scores can be collected and we can analyze it by putting into the graphical representations and all their worksheets, markings, everything can be graphically represented. And once if we represent through analyze this graph, we will come to know the performance of the students. Just by looking into the graph, we will come to know the performance of the students. And after I personally and our team teachers personally, when they check the observation, we were very happy and we were surprised to see the tremendous improvement in the performance of students, especially in this topic. So out of 100%, around 70 to 80% improvements were observed. This action research, there is no end for this process. Okay, it is a cyclic process. So once you finish, again, you can go through the same process, stage one, stage two, stage three, and stage four. And you can, it is a continuous process and you can continuously incorporate in your classroom teachings. So we did the same thing for the class nine. We had done this research and we wanted to check when they go to class 10, how far they still remember the way we have taught them how to crack assertion and reasoning question. So when they came to class 10, we assigned similar questions to them through worksheets as a bridge course. And we also incorporated many methods of teaching, like teaching through concept boards, through learning experiential activities, by doing different experiments and by framing questions by the students on their own and then analyzing themselves. And then peer discussion, they can pose the questions to their friends and their friends will analyze the statements and they will solve it. So these were the different interventions and different strategies we have used to make the concept, to give the concept clarity for the students. At last, like if I have to conclude, our topic was assertion and reasoning. And after we went through all these steps of planning, then using different strategies in the classrooms, discussion with my team members, and then spending time with my students, with my teachers, explaining them what to be done, and then allotting separate timings for conducting these research methods by using different strategies. So with all these, even though there was a lack of time, we tried our best to deliver the best to our students so that their learning outcomes will be the best. Okay, so it was really a nice journey, I can say. Of course, it took long time, around 6 to 8 months, but at end, the result was very satisfied. Okay, so we ourselves could reflect on our teachings, on our views. Okay, and we were able to modify the way we teach. Okay, all our weakness, we converted into our strength. All the weakness of students, we were able to identify and we personally talked to them and we guided them how to strengthen themselves, how to convert their weakness to their own strength. Okay, so through this action research, we were able to involve with the students, we were able to mingle with the students. The conversation was superb. So we were able to bond. Okay, so bondage of students and teachers are very important in schoolings. So through this research process, we were able to bond with our students. And what else we need as teachers in this profession, more than bonding with the students and then getting the best results. I thank my teammates, my colleague teachers for supporting me and involving in my research also. We have collected the feedbacks, anecdotes from the parents, positive anecdotes, and then students' reflection. The whole process which I have explained here, the reference is from CBSE Action Research course in Diksha portal. I can proudly say that we are our team teachers. Most of the teachers in our school, we have registered for this course. And 70 to 80% of our teachers, we have completed this course. And thank you for Principal Ma'am for supporting us and encouraging us to take part in this action research course in Diksha portal. Learning is more effective when it is an active rather than a passive process. So just we listen the process and we just keep quiet. No, we have to include in our daily classroom practices to improve our learning and teaching. So with this, I close my presentation on what is action research and how we went on with the science subject. Thank you. Now we will move on to maths. I request Savita ma'am to discuss her interventions in the subject maths and to share her interventions. Thank you, one and all.
Thank you, Pratibha ma'am. That was a wonderful informative session. Yes. Yes. Myself, Savita, I'm from Maths Department. Now, we have taken the topic for action research on division of decimals. Yes. Now, the steps. Teachers, kindly mute. Yes. I request teachers to kindly mute. Yes. Now, I'll be taking through the steps on introduction, objectives, causes of the problem, analysis, tools, and experimental design. And my co-teacher, Ms. Neeta, she's going to take through the session on procedure of data collection, data analysis, results and interpretation, and reflection. Now, why we have chosen this problem exactly? See, we all know decimals is used not only in maths, even in other subjects also, right? And not only in, the subjects, also in, you know, in daily life situations, you know, we calculate using decimals, normal numbers. So we felt decimals is a very, very important concept. Now, in that, decimals has a lot of, different types of, topics like conversions, many types like this. Now, in that, we felt that division of decimals was, you know, most difficult one for the students. You know what happens here? Division of decimals, they'll try to divide like a normal division, which does not happen in this decimal case. So we chose this division of decimals numbers as our action research. Now, and you know, you also know that this is a strong base, you know, the grade 5. This we have done mainly for grade 5, and it builds a strong base. And you know, it continues grade 5, 6, 7, 11, 10th, and also throughout the maths problems. So this is very important concept, and it develops a strong base from grade 5. The main objectives of action research is to analyze the problem faced while solving division of decimals. So we have to, think over where exactly they have gone wrong, where we have to improve all those things. Then to encourage to solve the problem independently with proper procedural knowledge. So many times, they will try to copy the same replica. Only numbers will be different. They'll try to copy the same type of problems. So they have to learn to solve independently. Main focus is that. And also to discourage the habit of cramming the solutions or answers. Now here what happens, during the exam times, they will start reading. As you all know, some students, only during exam times, they will start working out. Or sometimes they will make a lot of, mistakes, seeing the textbook and, the solutions, they'll just copy the, without making the proper calculations, they'll, calculate, they'll write the final answers. So to discourage the habit of cramming, we did this research. Then also to improve the logical thinking process. So logical thinking process is very important. Now, based on this classroom teaching experience, we found few causes of the problem, like difficulty in understanding the concept, then lack of previous knowledge. They'll have nowadays, this is the main problem we are facing, lack of previous knowledge. As we all had online classes, they have many things they are missing, many concepts they're not able to learn. Then even lack of interest in subject, they are these days, some will say, I'm not interested in maths, I'm not interested in English. So that also might be one cause. Then students is suffering from dyscalculia. This also might be one cause, like, they might be very weak in even calculating basic things. Now I would like you to share your opinions with this question, dear teachers. You can put in a chat. The question is, list any other challenges students may face while solving decimal concepts. You can also even unmute and tell me your opinions. List any other challenges students may face while solving decimal concepts. Yes. any other, any, it can be wrong or right, doesn't matter. It can be any type of, you know, problems they face while solving the decimal concepts, or even any other mathematical concepts also, doesn't matter. Yes. Okay, I think it might take one or more minute. And this, yes, very good. Previously learned wrong and trying to apply that. Very good and very good opinion. Place values. Yeah, they might go wrong in place values also. Addition while, respect to place values. Yes, yes. Might go wrong in also. So like this, you know, decimals, you know, of course, addition and subtraction place values, they might go in finding the place values also, conversion, like that. Yes, thank you so much for your valuable feedback. Now you all know that. Yes. Now, see, when we did a few pre-tests, you know, pre-tests, we found common errors, which matters a lot for analysis of the problem. Like you can see in the sample, we have collected few samples. I request teachers to mute. Yes, thank you. Thank you. So here you can see concepts not clear to the students. Might be they did not understand well. Then shifting decimal points was not correct. So they might feel difficult where to shift, how to shift the decimal places. Then even here, placing decimal points in quotient was not correct. So placing decimal points, again, shifting. And here this calculia, even lack of previous knowledge, like this, different types of mistakes we found. Okay, now keeping all this in mind, we made few hypotheses. Now this hypothesis is nothing but it's a testable prediction, like what we expect will happen in a certain circumference. Like we made few hypotheses, like if teacher solves more number of problems on the blackboard, then children would not feel so difficult. Or if teacher creates their own questions, which are not found in textbook, then the tendency to copy the answer from textbook would be reduced and they might feel more interest. So like these few hypotheses which we had made and helped us for the research. Now, we did a few designs based on this hypothesis. Teaching, reteaching, then a lot of worksheets we gave, pre-test, post-test, questionnaires. And for this, we collected few tools. Like it helped us a lot for action research. And also here we found that very interesting for one or two concepts to teach. We had to find so many types of tools which will help the students, even for us also, teachers also. Like here we did pre-test, worksheets, interviews, homeworks, intelligent test, lab activity materials, on then online quiz and so on. A lot of things we found to know. Now here, based on all these causes, many types of interventions, you know, where we feel very interesting, and of course it is little bit a long process, but once you get used to it, really it's a wonderful methods. Now here, estimation of decimals. So we did the estimation of through estimation decimals. We thought through, you know, multiplication by powers of 10. Then here through blocks method, as you can see in the samples, through block methods also, even dividing your for whole and, decimal divisions. And also we thought through real life applications also. And here you can see one, this bar model. Even through this also, they could represent the decimal divisions. And now here we did a small type of teaching called as reciprocal teaching. This was very interesting. Children were very excited. Now, what is this reciprocal teaching? It's a dialogue between teachers and students in which participants take turns assuming the role of teachers. Now they will act as a teachers. Student teachers, and they will teach. Here the interaction was very, very effective. So even teacher felt satisfied, and they shared a lot of doubts, their outcomes very well. Now here reteaching, we also did reteaching where children found more difficult or which was not fully covered. We did many reteachings. Now you can see in this sample, the child is independently working on the board. When we gave the sum, he was able to independently work out. Now also we all know that we are used to now digital teaching. So to digital teaching also, like showing them through stories, we also thought that it was very effective. Then also this is a new type, which is Happy Classroom. We also integrated decimals through Happy Classroom. Children beautifully, they created stories on decimal concepts. Now one such sample I would like to read what child has. Like here, we gave on the spot this this concept. Okay, decimal concept. So I would like to read one such small story what child has written. It was a perfect pizza party. I would like to kindly mute. Yes, thank you so much. Yes, yes. Can you mute? Yes, thank you so much. So I would like to read quickly. Once upon a time, there was two best friends. One day they met at their friend's birthday party. She ordered pizza for three of them. So she ordered one large pizza, which had seven slices. They three tried to share equally, but they couldn't do it. Can you figure out how can they share pizza equally among themselves? So the child, she worked out and she found that those three friends, they had got 2.3 part of the pizza. This was a wonderful, we all enjoyed. She also expressed in the class that was a wonderful experience. Like this, many children had done with their own stories. Next. Yes, also we did through math lab activities. We connected through different lessons and integrated. You can see here money through shopping. We had made them a shopping situation and the children were doing, and they had to represent and calculate through division decimals. Here also measurements, the child is measuring her own friend with her tape and even with the other objects, and they had to again represent through decimals. Now here, like this, we did many more interventions and we found, lot of difference, who were all weak. They've also started finding very interesting after this. They started, ma'am, when will we do other methods? Please teach us this, that. So really it was very satisfying, and we found still we have to, dig it up. Now through this, keeping on this basis, learners were able to analyze the decimal concepts to calculate the quotients. They were able to estimate the quotients very thoroughly. They're able to divide all type of numbers, and also they were able to differentiate between normal division and decimal division also. And also they were able to apply decimal division concept in real life applications. So this was a wonderful journey for us both, teachers and students. Now I would like to and you to share your opinion again. Now, what other teachers' teaching strategies can we use to make the concept more clear? You can type in the chat. The question is displayed on the screen. Or even you can unmute and tell the answer. So what other teaching strategies can we use to make the concepts more clear? You can even give a simple words. As we all can share different ideas. Yes. Yes, recapitulation, very nice. very good response. So even we can do by recapitulating the, you know, concepts. Yeah, drill work, very good. That's a, you know, great, you know, great practice for children. Yes, yes, comparing concepts with life examples. Yes, thank you so much. All are answering very well. Hands-on experience, daily life, exactly. Measuring the length of the leaves. Yes, yes. Connecting it to the, you know, different daily lives situations. Yes, thank you so much, teachers. That was a, you know, a good response from your side. Now, I would like to call upon Mrs. Neeta to take over the session. Thank you all.
Thank you so much, ma'am. Okay. Good morning to one and all present here. Myself, Neeta. So as Savita ma'am spoke about different interventions applied on students, I would like to add upon further methods which we actually wanted to know what can be done to for the development of the kids, students. So the idea was about this research was to understand about importance of doing mixed research, particularly in the case of evaluation. So we collected few data through certain procedure by providing worksheets. Also, we provided them online games and quiz. By which it was really helpful for us to analyze where the students are standing in the understanding of concepts, especially in the concepts of estimating, multiplying, or dividing the decimal division. Initially, when we gave them, when we analyzed the data, we provided them a pretest in which we understood that the students' performance was not up to mark, because we understood there are some loopholes or the students had to be trained in particular concepts. So we provided, we tried to learn about it as a teachers, but now you could see as we provided a pretest, the scores which the students have scored as is being tabulated, and the percentile is really dropped where the students' concept learning was not up to mark. Then we had to introduce a certain intervention. As Savita ma'am said, we also provided them interventions. We taught them through reteaching, reciprocal teaching, and many other methods like AIE, MATLAB activities. After all these methods, we gave them post-test in which the students were able to do it very well. So the performance was up to very good. And the scoring where the students were lacking in their concepts also was developed. So this is how it helped us to understand how the students could be developed in particular field. And this is the tabulated score of the post-test and also the percentile in which we can see the students' performance is really developed. So qualitative analysis is like we provided them classwork, homework, in which and through interventions also the students were able to understand different methods to learn the concepts. Finally, the results what we got was really good. The students had better experience to learn in a very good way, and they were able to understand the concept decimal division in a very good way. So this is nothing but we also took the teacher's anecdote in which all the teachers as a team in which we worked on research. It was really helpful for us to understand what methods can be implemented to the students. Initially, when we started with pretest, we understood that the students' performance was not up to mark, but gradually there was some development after intervention. That is what is being given by many teachers. As I said, it's a great platform for us as a teacher to learn the methods of teaching, and also it was helpful for us. And even parents, parents were not like as they saw the students' activities or the performance in the classes was not up to mark. So after we introduced these kinds of methods to the students, even the parents were really satisfied. You could see the feedback of the parents. So they were very happy with the students' performance. We also took students' anecdote in which Initially, as we understand, as a teacher, we see that the students may get diverted by many distractions in the class. Maybe they are not interested to learn if we are using very typical method. But after introducing many methods, even the children also enjoy through online source or digital teaching, even many other math activities. So even this is the feedback of the students where they were able to participate positively. So as I just said, online games, it was a great platform for the students also to learn very well. And finally, the conclusion, what we understood was, initially the students were struggling in the concept of decimal division, but gradually after research, we know that the students were really developed. It's not only that, going further, when we give a proper foundation at the initial state, as they move ahead to their further levels, the students were really able to do it, in the sense they could integrate these concepts, even the chemistry, physics, and the decimal division was really helpful for them to do it very well. So the bibliography is like, we had a certain resource to go through this research, especially Diksha portal was really helpful for us to do this research. Thank you so much. Now, I would kindly request all the teachers to, I will just share a small activity. So I would request you to please participate in that activity. I will share a link in the chat box. Kindly, please accept that activity. Yeah. Yeah, dear teachers, I have shared an activity here in the chat box. Please get into the link and you will get an activity being accessed. I hope my screen is visible, dear teachers. There is a question.
Yes, ma'am, it's visible.
In an intervention-based action research process, which of the following is usually recommended sequence? Oh, thank you. Already one teacher has been. Many teachers are participating. Thank you so much, teachers. Yeah. Oh, that's nice. So I think observe, plan, and act is in. Yes. Yes. I could see the many results. Many teachers are participating. Thank you so much. Oh, that's great, really. Okay. Thank you so much, teachers. So here, there is a competition between two options, that is observe, plan, act, and reflect, and plan, act, observe, and reflect. I hope as we know the process of intervention in action research, there is one sequence. So, okay.
Neetan ma'am, you can go for the next question.
I hope my screen share is not done. Just a sorry for that. Yeah. I hope you could see the results now. Yes. So many teachers. Thank you so much. So around 15 teachers have participated. Okay. So I think I could tell, share the correct answer for this question. Answer is plan, act, observe, and reflect. So I think so gradually it has come to the first position. So this is the right answer. Thank you so much for all. Thank you so much, teachers, for the participation. Okay, now I will move upon to next subject. Over to Shashi ma'am. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Neeta ma'am. Thank you, Neeta ma'am. Good afternoon to one and all present here. Myself, Shashi, from English department.
Give me a minute. My talk. So friends, as you can see that this whole area of action research, our teachers have deep dived into common errors. It started with the concept of common errors that we find when the children attempt their answers. And we had documented every time we have a test, the teachers document the common errors and we share it with the student community, parent community, tell everybody that the children are finding difficulty in this area. And we used to rework on those areas, giving them certain rubric points which children could refer and see as to how they are progressing so that they become independent learners as well. So if there was a paragraph writing, points like topical sentence, closure sentence, details, examples, cohesion, these points were to be highlighted and children used to work. But eventually when this action research, which was proposed by CBSE, we thought that let us make it more scientific and we went on to work on common errors, which evolved into becoming action research. Topics like assertion and reasoning was taken at the school-wide level in all classes. If you are ready, Shashi, I will.
As for the English topic, we had taken letter writing as our topic, as letter writing is especially the formal letter writing is very much required in their day-to-day life, and also it's a very definite question in their board exam. So here we have different formal letters: letter of inquiry, letter of complaint, and letter of, so placing order, letter to editor, like this. So we have different formal letters. So here, first and foremost, we took them through the marking scheme, because marking scheme, if they know the marking scheme, definitely they do it better. So format, content, and expressions are the three main stages in a letter writing, so that they will know how exactly they should go through, what exactly they should do in each step. So next is collecting the data. So as and when we gave the practice for them in the classes, so we could see some errors. So common errors, what we call. So many students were going wrong in their format, and some of them were going wrong in their grammatical errors, formal language, use of formal language, all this. Even we collected the data from the worksheets, classroom, which they've solved in the classrooms, and mock test, formative assessment, all such. Even in their previous exams also, when we checked, the same kind of mistakes were there. So we thought, so let us go through and address these problems. So here are some samples of their errors. So address, sender address and receiver address is mixed up. Then date, format. And here we can see subject is not proper. And even the flow of the letter also is not proper. We can see the errors in address and salutation missing. Subject is too long. All such errors were seen. So this is the quantitative analysis we have collected. So many many students were going wrong in the format and also the use of formal language. So this is graphical representation of that. And here, designing the hypothesis for the improvement of their errors. So here we had the sessions from experts, and we took showed them some videos from the webinars, different webinars, workshops, and also graded worksheets and guided worksheets also were given for them to overcome these difficulties. So these were the formats given, wherein they have to fill in some of the things so that they will know the exact format, how it looks, and also they'll get an idea how exactly a formal letter looks like. So here we have shown them some samples of sample papers from CBSE site, so that they'll get an idea how exactly it looks. And here, as CBSE also has introduced recently this multiple choice, this also was a very great help for the students, as they get different options to choose in different stages of letter. So it was really helpful for them, especially when they have to choose the subject, how exactly the subject should be, how exactly the conclusion should be, how to begin a letter in the introductory part, all this. So these are some sample questions we gave them so that they will be confident to solve the questions given. So these are some post-test samples we have collected. So we could see the errors are minimum here. So they have reduced the errors. So now they are almost confident to write an errorless formal letter. Yeah. So in this action research, before the action research, as I showed you some samples, they were going wrong in format. Somewhere formal language also, as it is a formal letter, formal language is very much required. And also relevant point and organizing the points. So they were missing it. So once we introduced and used this interventions using different teaching methods, after we understood their difficulties, where exactly they are facing different difficulties, so we were able to solve their problems or issues, overcome the issues after this action research. Really, this action research is very helpful for teacher, as a teacher. Really, I felt this was a great training for me. I can say it was a good training for me so that I can improve my teaching, especially languages are not easy because it's all depend on their creative writing. So if they know the method, how to go about it, definitely they will do better. So really I feel it has made me a better teacher. So next, moving on to the next. So these are my anecdotes from my colleagues. So these are students anecdotes. They also are confident now how exactly a formal letter to be written. So here are some parents' reviews also. And now let's quickly recall the steps. So these are the steps of action research. Identification of the problem. First and foremost, we have to find out what is the problem. Then define the problem. What exactly is the problem? Here in my topic, it is formal letter, format, content, all this. Then collecting the data. So from the students' work, we collect the data, where and all they go wrong, and how much, quantitative and qualitatively, we test the data. Then design the interventions, design the tools according to their need. That is most important. So here is the real action takes place. So where we help the students according to their needs. Then these are all the processing stage. And the last one is report writing. Once we do all these steps, we go for the report writing so that it will be helpful for the next teacher to go through the thing, whatever we have done. And it will be helpful for them to go take up the action research. So this is the whole summary of today's session. So action research, what is action research? What are its characteristics? What are the different steps we use in action research? And also the last is the report writing. So this is done at the last stage. Hope you all can recall this summary. Now I hand over the session to Pratibha Madam for the question. The session. Over to Pratibha Madam.
Thank you, Shashi ma'am. Thank you for sharing your best practices here. We are almost to the end of the session. It's time to fill up feedback form now. The link is posted in the chat box. Please take your 2 minutes. Your feedback is very valuable for Hub of Learning, KK1175, to ensure we are meeting the educational needs. We would appreciate if you could take a few minutes to share your opinion with us so we can cater to your needs better. Meanwhile, any questions from audience, so that we can take up those questions and we can discuss on that. Any questions?
Yes. Dear teaching fraternity, on behalf of Hub KK1175, our group of schools comprising of Delhi Public School Electricity, St. Sophia Convent High School, Assisi School, the Academy of Learning, and JSS Public HSR, Bengaluru. We now hope that we have made an event. It is an organic program, and especially action research was something very new in our school as well. Believe you me, for a pedagogical leader, it was an action research in action research, wherein I had to, again, deep dive our team of teachers to do action research. All that is required essentially is being a reflective practitioner, which we all are. But if it is put in the right order, the things become very easy. And subsequently, we all develop a habit of mind of inquiry, which is scientific, related to cause and effect, and also look into new findings which emerge from the actions that we take. So the interventions become important. We reflect and do action and redo. So while I speak, I am also reaching out to my principal colleagues of the hub of other schools at Delhi. If Priyanka madam is also there, most welcome to share your thoughts, ma'am. It will be nice. From Maxford School, my principal colleague, and other principal colleagues of a group of schools, if you are present, please share your thoughts. It would be very meaningful. So we are awaiting principals. If you are there, please just raise your hand and we will unmute you. I would say, teachers, yes, it was an uphill task. It wasn't easy and it is work in progress. We are backed by CBSC. They have given a very interesting, easy to do action research module. And each teacher has taken the thing. Basically, the whole thing is the teacher. The topics were selected by the teacher. The teacher feels that this is a need that I need to address. And it is endless. It is like infinite. It's not at all. It's very dynamic. It is live. It is infinite. And the journey goes on. That's how it is. You know, the more you get into it, the more you want to understand how to go. Certain things become your tool set. Like you heard the teacher saying the storyboard or reciprocal teaching or digital means, question answers, Kahoot, experiments, MATLAB activities, writing to the editor in reality, all these becomes your repertoire, which you can use any which ways, whether you're teaching this subject or that. But if we have to prepare our children for the future, then we have to equip them with certain skills and competencies so that they also don't find their work very challenging as they move on. So if a teacher is reflective, obviously she will enable the children to be reflective also and develop certain metacognitive skills, which will help them also to learn better. When we talk about metacognitive skills, we can simply use known strategies like Edward de Bono's thinking hats, or, you know, the graphic organizers, like the Venn diagram, flowchart, or plus minus interesting, what went right, what went wrong, exit cards. All these are very important because ultimately the sole purpose of the teaching and learning is to make learning a happy affair. That's the whole idea, to make the learning a happy affair. Just like the children like to go to play or like to sing and music and dance, wherever there is action, that's where we want to be, isn't it? Even in the school, as pedagogical leaders, we want to go into a class where there's some action happening, or wherever there's a playground or music or dance, because that's where we are involving ourselves, we are embedded in, energized, we are active, the participants, and then teacher's role become of a co-learner, because our children is the father of the man. The child is the father of the man is what we really, really understand. So yes, it was a challenging task, but having reached this far, now we don't think that it's very difficult to move on, and we are ready to share if anybody wants to reach out for any specifics. The YouTube link, this will be on in the YouTube as well as Vidya Shakti series. And so that's how we have been able to move on, onwards and upwards. Is any teacher wanting to share any questions? We are most welcome. Otherwise, we will be happy to close our session. Pratibha, do you have anybody speaking? Anybody from our partner schools? Veena madam, namaskara.
Namaskara.
Bala khushi aage den, you bandi devi. recovery agide bahala khushi ide. I'm deliberately speaking in Kannada so that our friends from other part of the country understand that there is a regional language and we are proud. Aur Hindi bhi hamari matrabhasha hai, hamari rajya ki bhasha hai, humko bahut garv hai. So welcome Veena madam, your thoughts on the series. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you very much. And sincere appreciation for the entire team. This topic in itself requires a lot of preparation, the action research, right? And the moment we hear this term, the action research, the only subject that comes in our mind is the science or maximum maths, that's all. Nothing beyond that. But your teachers have proved something which is possible in every subject, how this action research can be a helping tool for the teachers to make it the entire education or the practice to be the most interesting one. So I'm really happy. I thoroughly enjoyed the way how you people have brought those ideas and how successfully you have implemented in those classes, which I'm sure that we all are learning from each other. And in true sense, HOL KK1175 is bringing the collaborative practices. So wonderful presentation. Congratulations to each one of you. Thank you very much. And I feel really proud to be a part of this HOL team.
Thank you. Veena ma'am, for being the voice of KK1175. As we always say, we are the voice of KK1175. Our teachers are the voice of KK115. The fraternity of teachers are also the voice of KK1175. We have really moved as a hub, I must say, that collectively we are moving onwards and progressively and moving, you know, at a rather high velocity with both direction and speed. So we shall leave no stone unturned. We have Assisi School. Thank you, ma'am. Assisi School, Prema Madam, coordinator of Hub of Learning with us, sharing her thoughts under the guidance of Sister Sheba.
Good afternoon, respected Principal Geetika, ma'am, of JSS School, and respected Principal Veena, ma'am, and the team of JSS, and all other principals and teachers and the educators. It was really this today's session, action research, was very, of course, very wonderful session. And complete idea and the structure of action research, step by step. And it is not a work done in one day or in one week. It's a very lengthy process and very collaborative, collective work done by the team of JSS. And this, in the feedback, there was a question. One takeaway from this session, I felt all the steps very from today's session. I must congratulate.
Ma'am, you're in mute, ma'am.
Yeah. Thank you, ma'am. I think from the beginning or now?
Now.
Thank you. So what I felt is the entire team, a lot of hard work, and the efforts you have input, the very good inputs that we have received from this session. Thank you very much. Again, once again, I congratulate the ma'am and the team of JSS. Thank you for the wonderful informative session. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you for giving me opportunity to speak.
Thank you, ma'am. Prema, ma'am. Do we have other partner schools with us? If anybody is there, most welcome. Teachers of our school who are part of this saga, this whole research. If anybody wants to share, how did it go? Most welcome. Any insights, any participating teachers, if you have any questions, you can play the devil's advocate. Most ready to, really happy to answer. Anybody? Is our other principal colleagues, other school teachers, anybody you want to say? Pranami ma'am, do you hear us? If you have any thoughts?
Is it echoing? Yes. Good afternoon to all respected principals, teachers of Hub of Learning. I hope the session was informative and as well as it was reflective also. And this session can help the teachers to overcome the difficulties where in the classroom or in the practical day-to-day life, and what are the interventions in different subjects are doable, and how group of students, different group of students, according to the level of difficulties or according to level of their understanding, these interventions can be incorporated in classrooms across the schools. So when we went through the training in the Diksha portal, I would like to say that the teachers, it is available in the Diksha portal action research training. Everybody can go through it. They have a detailed program on it. And that helped us, actually. That helped us in identifying the problems. So we teach sometimes, but we feel that we do not always, topic, a particular topic, suppose I teach English and in the letter writing. So different group of students, we found that it is not that one area difficulty faced by all the students. Different group of students faced difficulties in different areas. So some were not comfortable in the sentence structure, some were not comfortable in the, and it is an era of email, it is an era of text messages, so formal letter somewhere, how it will be applicable, how they, it can be applicable in the real life situations, that also we need to develop, that interest also we need to develop. So these interventions, the activities, the hands-on learning can definitely help them. So I hope teachers, we had all the subjects teachers have presented, I hope it was helpful. It was, the information can be incorporated in all the classrooms. Thank you again. I'm happy to be a part of this program. Thank you, Principal Ma'am, to give us this opportunity to present our, to share our learnings. So the best practices, we same, at the same time, we are learning from other schools, the best practices. Thank you so much.
Very well put, Pranami madam. Thank you very much. So is it time to close, Pratibha ma'am?
Yes, ma'am. I, on behalf of JSS Public School, HSRR Bangalore, and the entire fraternity of the school, I extend my sincere thanks to all principals, teachers, and colleagues for cooperative listening and active participation in this session, and making it a meaningful and a successful session. Thank you for the technical support rendered by JSS technical team, the backstage representatives, and each and everyone who involved in the success of today's section. Thank you, one and all. Sarve jana sukhino bhavantu. Namaste to all.